I'm Clint Oliver from BlackVibes.com right now. I'm here with Mama Tula from 95.5 The Beat.
Okay,
let's start off with your career in radio. How long have you been a radio person?
A long time, about 9 years.
How did you get your start?
Actually, I came to Atlanta. I'm from Wisconsin. I came to Atlanta to get a job interview. So what happened was, I went to my room and said, $500 a week. Met Mark Meadows, which is the name on the radio. And he was like, I'm looking at you, Sam. If you want to come, can I answer for you? And the question was like, yeah. So I didn't really realize at that time in my heart where I could get an internship. And I just worked hard. I felt like I had too much pressure. And Roger, I couldn't pay my bills. I didn't pay the fee. I didn't have no money. And then I got hard as a DJ. I kept coming to me. And then
Now, a lot of people go the school route and they get to broadcasting and go to a major institution, and other people go to the internship route and work their way up. Which way do you think?
Well, I have a big thing for broadcasting, so I really don't want to talk bad about things. But for me, a lot of people get hired to radio is through internship. Like, you could do all the school broadcasting school that you ever could do and never get hired. Because at the end of the day, it's your relationship with somebody you hire, your work ethic, your role, it's about who you know. So, internship all day. The sooner you get into the internship, the better.
Talk about the challenges that you being a female DJ in this industry.
Oh, yeah, because you don't have to be a female DJ, you don't have to be a female DJ. You don't have to be a female DJ. So, for the idea of female DJ, I mean, I don't know, like, it's kind of a double-edged sword because it's like you're going through the materials, you can do, it's still hard to get the door sometimes.
Talk about the new that experience in that part of your career.
Well, I mean, what I learned off of violence, like, it was right before the new days came about. So I appreciate that, because I carried the crates, don't get it twisted, I carried the crates, used the metals, thin crates, seven crates into the cab, vinyl, turntables, cell phones, you know. So, I mean, nowadays, you don't have these issues. They just push the button to get the new days. I just got the physical part, the natural touching point. Some people don't even want to leave, so I don't know. So, just like that whole, I taught myself, and then we tell other people that teach me how to say, you just have words and not use the words. You just got to help me a lot. But as far as the singing and the basement, really, you got to sing it and just keep going. I can do better. I need to do better. But they stay on us all day, all night. They barely come out to see. So it's just a lot of stuff.
What equipment are you using now?
Well, not only that, Colorado. Everybody starts with the same way you go to the media office. But a lot of people are starting to come back to turntables because it's a lot. you don't have to just get a laptop, external hard drive, and we're good. Well, yeah, my bag is almost that early. Right now, my bag is carrying on tapes. We're hoping everything will just start out on vinyl and carrying tapes, but it'll be a lot of things to do.
And when Vic goes right now as DJ Hero, have you guys got to play that game? What do you think about it?
Honestly,
I'm supposed to be taking pictures with it now, so I'm going to say it now, yet. But I know it's a good thing.
All my DJ friends
want to do that.
It's coming.
Some of the DJ friends, have they told you it's a real life experience,
and
what have you heard about
it? Someone told me I'm really going to do it. I don't know if they're going to do it. It's hard being a DJ.
Now, let's put you there for a second and talk about from the artist perspective. I'm pretty sure there's a lot of artists that know you on the radio. They always come to me and say, I got some music, I got some music, but it doesn't work like that. They just can't give you a CD and just put it on the air. You know, what advice would you give to an artist who really wants to be a
fan? Well, I mean, most of the artists, sometimes they're just saying, but Pete Stadler is now an urban, and our station would be the service, the urban station. It's two different worlds. Like, urban, you can probably go up there. You live in urban, you have to work in the streets. That's what I love about it. You have to work your song in the streets. It's just so hot and sweaty. But everybody's talking about it. You're going to listen to it on audio. I don't know what it is in other markets, but in this market, it's like that. And in urban, radio jumps on record stations. So, you have to be really sorry for the most of the time. Unless he's just one of those independent organizations who seems that my programmer is just going to help me guide him on this particular thing. But for the most part, he really loves the streets. They always want to jump the streets by a hard grind or grassroots by one of those things. They don't want that. Don't get mad at me because I can't play the record. That's all I'm saying.
I'm pretty sure not only do you get a post for artists, but you also get a post, you know, me and one come at you, or you're always out in the public eye. You know, let's talk a little bit about your personal life. First of all, you know, what's the love life situation
right now? Well,
What do you do to get away from, I guess, caffeine, the radio station? What do you do to relax?
I don't know. I don't go home. You know, my family, thank you. But, like, people get it, like, a lot of people in church coming up to do things with their kids. This is a way of life. You can get, you be here for 4 hours or 5 hours and talk to them, and you go home and you do it. And if you really want to be here for a longevity time, then you have to make yourself in the way. You go home with it, you live with it, and to me, like, I was like, we always wanted to go take care. And you got to leave for the church. I'm like, I love to just stay home and go to do some regular stuff. And you don't understand that you can't do anything. I don't want to go to that stuff. You don't have to. I'll just be regular and be regular. Which I'm regular, but I felt my job is in this way right now.
Let's talk about your career outside of radio. What other things do you aspire to be in?
Well, I just got my little girl t-shirt line coming out. It's coming real soon. It's called Mini Mommy. And it's for pre-K to like 6th grade. So we have the meaning, the definition of what a Mini Mommy is in the back. It's got a really cute, star eyes, logo, and I'm just so excited. And I'm really excited to get those two little girls. I want the orange and yellow. The orange and yellow to wear on my shirt. And I want two.
And we appreciate the simple time of it.
This is me every day of your life. 6 p.m. every day, weekly, on Apple Podcasts.